Start the recording. I forget sometimes. You're going to back up in your space. And one thing, actually, don't do that yet. Stay here. I wanted to show you, anatomy is super helpful for dance for me. And so I have this picture, and it's hard to see, but I have a picture of the back of your spine. Can you all kind of see that? You have to get in close. And I want you to notice a couple of things. Do you see how far back your shoulder blades are? And then do you see how high your ribs go in the back? So do you see, like, this rib is actually higher than your collarbone in the back? So, and the reason I'm bringing this up is because we don't investigate this space much. And one thing that is really helpful for balances, especially as we do really spinny things and we let our head go, is if we think about the back of the ribs. And I think it's hard to think about unless you can visualize what they actually look like. So I just want to remind you, you have a rib that is higher than your collarbone. So when you're thinking about the whole back of you, instead of letting your head go forward, we look at a lot of screens right now, we can really think about the back. Now back up in your space. And we're going to just kind of remind ourselves that we're 3D. So you're going to start at the top of your head, and you're going to go down your face, Riley, go to your bed, and down your body, out. Down your body all the way to your feet. And then you're going to come up the back of your legs, and all the way up the back of you, you're going to have to probably cross your arms to feel your ribs, and then all the way back up. And you're going to do that a couple of times. So you're just brushing, and you're just feeling that your body is actually 3D. You have this whole thing. You're not a stick figure. This has been really helpful for me to feel what my actual body mass is. And then you can kind of give yourself some brushes down your arms and some brushes down your legs, down the back of your legs, and down the back of your head and your shoulders. Just kind of giving yourself some love here and your stomach. And you can kind of get more vigorous with the brushing, really give yourself some warmth. And when you feel like you've had enough, we're just gonna pick up that collarbone and that really high rib. You're gonna let it go, and you're just gonna drop them a couple of times. And as this is happening, you can just look around. You don't have to stare at the screen. You're just picking up your collarbones and dropping them, and picking them up and dropping them, and seeing past your screen and out your window. And you can look down at the floor, at your feet. You can let that get a little faster. Even higher, just letting those arms drop with your breath. Now on this one, you're gonna pick it up, drop it, then you're gonna grab your right wrist. You're gonna go up and over, dropping your right leg into the ground. And then you're gonna take your head towards the screen and let your knees move forward. You're just gonna take a little plie, see the back wall. And then you're gonna roll up. And your head's gonna get really high. And then you're gonna take your collarbones up. And then you're gonna get really wide. And then this time you're gonna grab your opposite wrist. Go up and over, dropping your left leg into the ground, taking your head forward, letting the back ribs actually be in back of you. See the wall, climbing up. So rather than trying to make ourselves flat, you're actually allowing those back ribs to take up space. You go a little deeper and move through this a little faster. And grab the opposite, head over, and take your head forward, and up.
Okay, so we're gonna start right away with some tendus. So you're gonna be in a nice parallel position right underneath your hips. And you're going to peel off your heel. You're gonna do two bounces. This should look kind of familiar. You pick your knee up, you do one big kick circle, find your heel on the ground, and then scoot it back. From here, we're just gonna start with doing three tendus and then a little plie. And then we'll go to the other side. This is the same, you pick up your knee, you do a big circle, your back ribs are actually going back when this is happening. You're gonna do three tendus and a little plie. Then the second time, after all of this, we're gonna do some vigorous tendus. You're gonna get really high on your standing leg and your head's gonna go really high up into the ceiling and you're just gonna brush past your parallel pretty vigorously. Okay, well then I'll say stop. And then you go forward and you'll peel your foot off and put it back. And then you'll rotate just a little bit, peel and back. Rotate just a little more, peel and back. And then just a little more, peel and back. And then from here, we're gonna take our elbows wide and you're gonna do little half rond de jambes. We'll do a bunch of these. And then we'll take that back forward and then a plie and then we'll switch sides. Vigorous tendus, you have your peel, your peel, your peel, your peel, basically until you get to second. And then we have these little rounds, getting really high up, feeling the back of your head, feeling the back of your ribs, and then finding that parallel and then plie. All right, let's just try it. Follow along. You have 5, 6, a 7, a 8. You have a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, a 5, a 6, a 7, a 8, a 1, a 2, a 3. Put it back. A 5, a 6, a 7, a 8, a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, and a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, and a 5, a 6. Pick it up. And a circle, ribs are far back and back. Here's your tendus, just three. And plie again with more tendus. 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, a 5, a 6. Pick it up, shoulders are wide and really kick it. Test your balance, bring it back. Here we go, and a brush. You're really feeling the floor. Your head is trying to reach for the sky. You're trying to take your hips really high above your standing leg, allowing your working leg to just be free, feel the ground, feel what's happening in the ground. And last two, and forward, and pick it up, and spiral, down, pick it up. And a spiral, and a pick it up, and a spiral, and a pick it up. Elbows go little circle. Same thing, try not to tighten your hips, they can be really released. Front of the pelvis can be high, and you can find your parallel plie, other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and a big circle. Put your heel down back. Here's those tendus. Get high, don't sink in your hip. Arms are just arms. Sensitive feet, really feeling the floor. Head can continue to be higher than you think. Two more. And a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, and a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, and a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, and a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4. Here's your circles. Elbows are as far away from each other as they can be. Really nice and high on the standing leg. Find parallel and plie. Hopefully you got a little bit of blood circulation here.
Next thing,
we're gonna go on to our little lunge, moving to this side of your room. You can really let your knees go forward. And then here, as you do your lunges, I want you to think about being in your backyard and like you're splitting blades of grass. So you're thinking more about the long leg than you are about the bent leg. Your pelvis is staying in between your legs. So I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do and then we're gonna do it together. So we'll do a couple of these. We'll flex, put it down. And then here, I want you to play with, as this plie is happening, one is gonna be turned in, one is gonna be turned out, for those of you who are new to this. And you're gonna actually allow your spine to twist and to kind of be 3D as it is. And then you take your arms really far out. You wanna take a little stretch here, take everything forward. Then your knee is gonna go side, and then you're gonna bring it to the front, really stretch it up, and then you're just gonna drop it. Let it be heavy. And then you'll face the other side. We have our little lunges, you turn out, you have your twists. So this is kind of like if you do a lot of yoga, it's like a warrior position. A lot of these, twists, forward, knee goes side, hold it, drop it. We'll do this right, left, right, left. Get high, re-find your parallel, re-engage your pelvic floor muscles, allow your knee to move forward and out, and head and shoulders are really high, not affected by the plie. You're just splitting grass in your backyard, thinking about that long leg, long leg, long leg, long leg. And you're gonna flex all five toes and put it down. And feel this new position. And you can add some twists. You don't have to press your pelvis down on your legs. You can actually lift it up so that it's not heavy. And then we'll settle, open up those fingers. We'll take them down and around. Knee goes side, grab it to the front. We'll stretch it for a second. Left leg can spiral down, drop. Face the front, other side. Knee goes forward and out, and little shifts. So there's a lot of energy in your feet, in the soles of your feet, because we're really trying to split that ground. Legs are moving away from each other. And all five toes lift and put it down, allowing your spine to twist, thinking about that long leg. And arms move forward. And circle down, take your head far forward so that you can find your standing leg. Knee goes out to the side and forward. Little stretch, right leg drops down into the ground. A couple more seconds and drop. Two more times, a little faster, and up. Just a couple, and a flex, and a twist. Nice and juicy, and really high. Fingers go, arms go. Leg goes to the side and grab it. And a drop it. Find the front and leg escapes. Little lunges, let your knees be free. Back of the ribs are going back and up as this is happening. Flex, let that spine be mobile. See the room around you. Stare at the screen, arms move forward. Go down and up, find that standing leg, turn out, find the front, hold, and drop. Good. From here, we're gonna go out into our turned out head rolls. This is really familiar for some of you. For some of you, it might not be. So we'll start by just preparing our turned out, stepping on a turned out leg, spiraling, stepping on a turned out leg, allowing that hip to release, stepping on a turned out leg, stepping on a turned out leg until we feel comfortable in this position. You take your head forward and side and back and side, then you push it a little further before you go forward. Now this is just a little baby down dog. I'm taking weight into my hands, moving it back. Then I'm taking my collarbones up and dropping them. And I'm shifting over to the side, and then I'm dropping an arm. And I'm picking it up, and I'm peeling my leg. And you do the other side. 2, 3, 4. Take your head further. 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. You drop on 5, 6, even 7, 8. Shift and drop and up and little peel. You want to, in this moment, I've reminded some of you before, but really counteract that other knee so that you don't topple over. Unless you want to topple over, then by all means, do it. We're going to do that twice in turned out first, twice in turned out second, and then a little faster, a little faster. I'm going to tilt this down just a bit. Here's your 5, 6, 7, 8, and a 1, 2, see the sky, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, walk it back, 2, up, 3, 4, 5, 6, nice and easy, 8, and a shift, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, catch it. And a pelvic floor muscles are working. And head stays high, even in a plie and a shift. And a drop, and a reach, and a peel. Other side and forward, and a back, and a further, and catch. And a back, and an up, and a drop, and a deep in, and a shift, and a drop, your arm and up. On that drop, think about your ribs. Second, 1, 2, ribs move backwards, still move backwards. 6, 7, 8, and a back. 2, knees go side, and knees go side. Head goes up. And a shift. Now think about your back ribs right here. Takes it out of your lower back and a peel. And a forward. Side. Head really sees the sky. Counter direct that knee. Catch. Walk it back. In and up. And a drop. And shift to the side. And a drop. Catch. Little peel, 2 more times, forward, side, back, side, and deep in, 6, 7, 8, start to create some heat in your belly, really leaving that head high and deep in, take it further, and a drop, and a further, and a peel, and a forward, side, back, and a side, and a further, 8, and a back, and a up, and a deep in, to the side, a little deeper, and a drop, pick it up, faster, hold 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, ready, go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, I'm eating my hair, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, keep going, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, back, keep that breath going, other side. A little faster. shift, drop. Second position, same way. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Should be creating some heat. 2, 3, 4, 5. Pelvic floor muscles right here, right here, right here. Da, 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 and shift, and drop, and shift, and 2 more times, up forward, and side, and back, and side, and back. Nice and juicy the whole time, sensitive feet dropping into the floor, and side, and back, side, and forward, back, and up. Drop, shift, arm, reach, hand. Good. Get a drink of water if you want, or if you need. Okay, moving on to music, yay. Very simple. So, in first position, you do a plie bounce. Then you do a little rise. You don't have to go into your backspace. I'm just looking up because I don't like to look at the screen the whole time. Then you're gonna take your right arm and you're actually gonna take your head into space. So it doesn't have to be like a complete flat back, but I am taking my head really far this way. And then I'm gonna continue to take my head this way and continue to take my head this way, do a little back bend, come up. And then I'm gonna do a little grand, leaving my head high. Then I'm gonna do the other side, little rise, and down, then body circle, and big cambré, and grand plié. Yes, so we'll do that right left in first position, right left in second position. Clear enough? Give me a wave. Cool. Let's do it. Okay. You all hear this okay? One thing that I obviously wasn't watching, so I don't know how it was going, but one thing that I am constantly thinking about is taking my pelvis really high, because there's something about ballet and turned out in these positions that feels very forced and very held. And what I notice in these positions is that my pelvis feels very heavy. And so if you think about, it's not actually going to lift into the air, but if you think about taking your pelvis off your legs, and then you try those balances, and you keep thinking about your pelvis coming up, all of a sudden you can really access your highest releve, and you can balance for days because this isn't pushing down on your leg. So there's a couple places you can investigate that. One is here. So because we're going down, we're thinking pushing
So try that for yourself, really, on your own. Yeah, Cassie, I see that. Yes, Ashley, yes, yes, yes. And even further, I don't think you need to stop yourself. Yeah. Just have fun. Yeah, there's a lot of freedom in that. You don't have to hold yourself back. That's great. Cool. We'll move on though. So,
start at the back. Here's where we start building the combo.
So pay close attention to what's happening because it'll help you memorize the combo.
So, you're back here. You have out, in. You can't see from the side. I'm just doing a tendu and then pulling it in for starch. So I'm going slow, slow, out from a straight leg, shift towards the camera, shift back, and then three tendus. I'm gonna go this way first, so I'm gonna step on my right leg first. So you're gonna go step, step, and then really spiral. It's very easy to just kind of turn, like actually spiral your torso really high, and then you're gonna move your shoulders first. So shoulders are gonna go, leg is gonna go, elbow's gonna go, knee's gonna go. So they all have their own thing that's happening. So you just sit out, this is the same side. In, out, hand shift, and back. Six, seven, eight, and a shift. Release, spiral, long leg. Step on that leg, and shoulders go, leg goes, elbow goes, knee goes, step back, and together. Other side goes, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and shift, and spiral, shoulders, leg, arm, knee, and back. I'm gonna turn this way once so that you can see what's happening. So you go out, and then in, and then out, and a shift, and then back, in, in, in. Now take a step on that same foot that just moved. Spiral away from the camera. My left shoulder is going to go first. Left shoulder, left leg, left arm, left knee, back. Then you switch to the other side. Out, in, out, hand shift, and in, and in, and in. To the corner. You're spiraling, this time your right shoulder goes, right leg goes, right arm goes, right knee goes, and back. So you're finding your corners, and you're trying to, same idea, instead of going down with our pelvis, you're trying to think up with everything, stay up with your head, stay up with your head, all the way through that. Okay, let's try it. If you're like, yeah, I got it. Give me a wave if you're like, I'm a little confused where you're going.
Seems like everyone's in it. Okay.
So, great. We're going to do it again. Now, instead of letting your space track you, now I'm going to go all the way. I mean, I'm keeping an eye on that coffee table. That hurts when I run into it. But you're going to get close to things. So you're really feeling the edges. And especially your arms, all this stuff. When you move your shoulder, then move your leg. Try not to let everything sink. Try to go, whoo, up, up. And then you'll be able to really travel further. So I'm going to work on traveling further. And you're also going to work on that. One more time each time. We're gonna keep moving. So the next exercise, super fun. You have that big step, you take a big step on your right leg. You're gonna let yourself fall, and instead of thinking down on this leg, which is what we naturally want to do, we're gonna think about this long leg going away. So you're just gonna think about that long leg and come back to it. So it looks like up, down. Up, and then you're just going to take a little grapevine. Other side. Down. Up. Grapevine. Now this time you go through plie. Up. Grapevine. Through plie. Down. Up. Through grapevine-ish. When you do this, think about taking your ribs with you both times, and you want to stay away from making it super even. So you don't want it to look like here, I'm going to fall now, I'm going to rise now, right? Like I know you can do that because you're all advanced dancers. So instead, you're thinking about the long legs that you go rebound up, grapevine up, rebound up, grapevine through plie, rebound up, grapevine. And if your space is limiting to you, you can turn around and go back the opposite way, which is probably what I'm going to do and start going backwards. So the first time, we'll try and do it coming towards the camera. So we'll try and do like straight leg right left, bent leg right left. And then it's up to you what direction you want to go. If you've done this a bunch of times and you're really familiar with my class, you can really start to take your head into some falls. That can be really fun. Whatever, have fun and remember to keep going. This is how we get our heart rates up. So really push yourself on this one. Darker than the ocean, deeper than the sea. You got everything you got, what I need. Touch me, you're an electric babe. Move me, take me from this place. Move into the tempo, show me what it takes. Speeding up my heartbeat, playing in the flames. Kiss me, we're on fire, babe. Love me, take me to outer space. Kiss me, we're on fire.
So now we're gonna add on to that a little bit. Same sort of thing. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna take that big wide step, you're gonna take your fall, but then this long leg is gonna rond de jambe back, and then you're gonna do your shoulder, just like before. And this time we're gonna take a big double pay to the side, and then this really is, I'm kind of leaving it behind, so I'm not stacked on top of my body. I'm kind of already leaving with my head. And then I'm gonna dip my right foot, like I'm dipping it in a pot of honey. I don't know, I'm obsessed with honey right now. Here, and this feels like a three-step turn. So the same leg, your right leg, is going to go right, left, and this back leg is gonna spin around on a flat leg. So then you're gonna do a big, big body roll before you go other side. So that looked like you took a step, you fell, and right away you round the jambe. You take your head, you dip your foot in. This feels like a three-step turn. And then you're gonna take it step other side. And down. Down. This leg goes, this goes. Up, dip it in. This goes left, right, up. You're ready to go other side. I'm gonna turn this way so you can see. So you went up and you fell and you took your elbow, found your diagonal towards the camera, up. So you should be in this nice écarté here. Cross it in front. Let your body twist on this moment. I'm gonna go right, left. My left arm's gonna come up and over and then cut down before I take a step left and down. Now left leg spins, left leg up, dip it in, left, right, up, step. I'm gonna play the music for a second, see if you can figure out the sequence. Just on your own.
Covered in your water and I'm feeling like a summer breeze. Submitted on the power and you brought me to my knees.
Okay, so I'm going to read your mind. My guess is that the question is about the turn at the end. So when you're doing on this side, ba, 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 so you're going to take a step right and start turning your body, and then don't make this an arabesque. It's just going to throw you off balance. Instead, think about this as an arm circle and you're kind of dragging this one back. So my arm is doing the work, it's already up, and then all you have to do is let your head and everything go. So from this moment, my left elbow's cutting in, my head's going down, and then I'm stepping to the other side. So then on this one, from here, I'm taking a step left, right, my left is gonna circle back. But it's really a right arm circle. So all, it's a very small thing. I'm actually bringing my legs together and it's more about the body circle. So don't worry about it being like a big arabesque turn or anything yet. We don't have to go there. It stays on the floor. This is where socks come in, I think. All right. Y'all ready to try it? Give me a wave if you're like pumped to do this. Okay, cool. I like this song.
Darker than the ocean, deeper than the sea.
Towards or away?
You got everything you got, what I need. Touch me, you're electric, babe. Move me, take me from this place. Move into the temple, show me what it takes. Speeding up my heartbeat, playing in the flames. Kiss me where I'm fighting today. Love me, take me to all those places. Kiss me where I'm fighting today.
Love me. Cool. Hopefully that semi in there kind of comes back. So, moving right into the double bounce,
we have double bounce to the front, double bounce with your arms open, shoulder circle, right arm cuts open. Now this time, rather than our normal suits, you're really gonna cut yourself and actually twist. So you're gonna twist down. So twist down, up, twist, shoot your back leg back, snake through with your head, and then close. Then you're gonna do right elbow, left arm. So it's kind of like you're reaching for something that's out of your grasp. So all that was same side, forward, and a ripple, enjoy that shoulder circle. And you're gonna cut down, cut, snake, bring it in, elbow reach, little run to come back. And this move should be fairly familiar. You're gonna take a step up and over. You're gonna cut, really drop your head and really twist. So rather than this feeling like it's very flat, I want you to really think about those ribs, especially those high ones, and actually take those ribs back. Take the ribs back. Then you're gonna step other side. It'll go forward and forward. This is the other side. Little ripple, open up left, cut down. Cut, sneak out. This is your little snake. Bring it in. Elbow reach. Little rond. Then you're gonna go up and over. This time it's my right arm cutting. I'm gonna take my head off. Drop it. See the sky. Cut. Drop it. See the sky. And then you're just gonna find the other side. So if I do it this way, from the first one, go across, down, up, across, look, pull it in, right elbow, left arm, little cut. If it's the right side, you're gonna do that right arm, down, up, down, up, other side. Other side, from here, we'll go across, whoop, cross, up, elbow reach. This one goes this way, and this way.
Kind of makes sense. Okay, I've got some thumbs up. Let's dance to some Taylor Swift.
A dream high in the quiet of the night, you know that I caught it. Bad, bad boy, sunny toy with a price, you know that I bought it. Killing me slow, out the window, I'm always waiting for you to be waiting below. Devils roll the dice, angels roll their eyes, what doesn't kill me makes me want you more. And it's blue, shape me up, buddy, it's blue, the feeling I've got it is blue. Ooh. killing machine, I'm not dying. They say that we'll just screw it up in these trying times, we're not trying. So cut the headlights, summer's a knife. I'm always waiting for you just to cut to the bone. Devils roll the dice, angels roll their eyes. And if I bleed, you'll be the last to know. Oh, it's blue, shape of your body is blue. The feeling I got it is blue. Oh, it's blue, summer, it's blue. That's when I tell them no rules. Wake up on heaven, but
peeking to make sure you have the sequence or where I can help you. So that's all I'm doing.
So from this all seems pretty clear. So the same arm that does that cut, that's the leg that goes out. And then all you're doing is like picking your head up, and then when you come in, you bring everything back in. So that from this place, you're like powerful. And you're really trying to travel on that. Yeah. It's really like you want something from that moment. So right here, like, boom. Yeah. Same thing here. So with this arm, you just did one cut, that same leg goes out, you peek up, in, out of reach. Yeah.
And then I think you have mostly the cuts at the end.
It really is like your face goes away, but I'm really twisting towards the back. Face goes away, let your head go, and then really twist again. So your spine is really, really doing a figure eight there.
Yeah, yes. Okay, we're gonna do a little stretch really quickly. It just looks like this, I'll show you at once.
So you'll take your right arm over and you'll do two body circles. And on the second one, you're gonna pull yourself forward. So it's that same little like head dives forward little stretch. And then you're gonna push your heel down and try and even out your hips. And then from here, you're just gonna take a little lunge and you're gonna take your head really far forward so there's lots of room for your legs, and you're gonna take a big step forward with that arm that's closest to the screen, and then you're just gonna take a big arc, and then you're gonna reach towards the screen and you're gonna turn that into a side extension here, and then from here all you're gonna do is pull it in the first position and roll up, and then you're ready to take it the other direction. So you'll go this way, whoo, over, kind of put your heel down, take a lunge, step that arm forward. You can even go on your elbow, little side stretch, bring it in.
We'll just keep that same sound going because it's so nice.
Oh,
So let's do, it's almost 1:30 now, and I didn't want to go later than 1:40. I like to stick to an hour and a 10 at the latest. I feel like even an hour and 15 feels really long these days. I'm just tired of Zoom, y'all. I know you are too. So we'll try and end it a little sooner. So let's go into the combo. So there's a few little changes about, we know all the ingredients, but they're just gonna change just a hair. It's gonna look like this. So we're gonna do this side first, actually, because it'll be your right arm working. So you're gonna take a step this way, and you're gonna do that same little head. Yeah, so you just do one of them. Now this leg is free, which would be my right leg. I'm gonna find that diagonal, and I'm gonna spiral just like we did before. And then from here, I'm gonna take my shoulders, leg, and elbow. And then I'm gonna go into this guy, my little développé dip. I'm gonna take my left leg, go left, right, that circle. Now here's where it gets a little tricky, and I'll face away too. So instead of facing the front, I'm going to actually do a full circle on this. And whatever leg, so this would be my right leg back. And so it feels like what happened was, I just snuck that leg out from under me. And I'll turn the other way so you can see. And then I'm going to actually spiral again. So I'm going to go towards the back wall. And then I'm going to do that explosion that we did before. Whoop! And then I'm just going to take myself back for the other side. I'm going to face you for the other side, and then we'll do both sides facing away. So you have this guy. Whoop. From here, you're going to find your diagonal, your little spiral, shoulders, legs, elbow. You take your little développé, dip it in. This time it's right, left, around. Woo! Yeah, so it would be the opposite leg. Then you're gonna come back up. This time it's right or left arm, right arm, around. This is much easier facing the other way, so I'm gonna do it. So you have up and over. Here, I'm gonna find this diagonal, so towards the camera. Then from here, I'm gonna spiral right shoulder. Then I'm gonna do right leg, dip, ba, ba, ba. Oh, this is so hard to face away, oh my gosh. Ba. You're going to, hold on, let me think about this. This is making me be so smart having to switch around and shout different legs that I'm actually using. So, okay, so if you're doing your right side, your left leg is gonna come out into that lunge, okay? So, let's say we're going this way. Even if we said we weren't before, let's say we are. Let's say we're doing this. It's going to be the left leg that moves first. My right shoulder, right leg, right elbow, right développé, right leg. This is going to go right, left. Drag that leg, and then, so I was dragging my right leg, but then I'm going to push out my left. That'll make it a little easier. And then you're gonna pull it back in and you're gonna go left, right. And if all of this is confusing, because it is, it's really hard. I'm asking you to be super, super smart. Then just improv. It's also great. So the other side, if this is our second side, then we're gonna go up and over. Then my right leg's gonna go and I'm gonna spiral. My left shoulder, left leg, left elbow. We should all be pretty good on this part. Ba-ba, dip. Here's where it gets a little hard. Go left, right, right arms up, right leg's gonna go out.
Then I'm going to turn away from the front, so the opposite way of the screen, up, so that I can go right elbow, left arm.
Does that make more sense? Slow start, but hopefully you're figuring that out. Okay, so let's just try some things. I think it's easier to just dance it, and sometimes you figure it out as you're dancing it, which is helpful so that we're not just talking about it. Okay. Tried it that I can break down for you? Questions? It's fun when you get it. It's not fun if you don't. So if you have a question, ask me, because then you can mess around with this later and super fun. No questions? Just a matter of doing it? Yeah. Totally, Ashley. It's just so circular. Yeah, exactly what you just did. That's right. Yeah, so it's like you're winding one way and you unwind the other way at the end. That's exactly right. And so when you're doing all of this, one thing that's really fun to explore is like, okay, if I were just like a really long piece of Laffy Taffy, I don't think they make these anymore, but at camp, they used to have these like watermelon Laffy Taffy, and they had little like gum seeds in it. They were so good. And it was like hot pink. But like I think about my body trying to be as long as possible, even though we're in small spaces, because really this doesn't move very much. And so here's a good place to think about it. So right here, try to get as long as possible so that my knees are as far away from each other. That way my head can really like get wiggly. So you should feel like a bobblehead doll right here. So you go high on that leg and it's like your head just goes everywhere. So it really like goes for a ride and it's super fun when you do it. So really see the back here. Now here, actually twist enough that you can see yourself in the camera and then go shoulder. So don't go shoulder and leg. From here, move your shoulder, then move your leg, then move your arm. And then from here, this is all pretty normal. And then here, option two, if you're really understanding that turn, you can really let your head go on that. It's a little scary, but you can really let your head go because it really helps push that other leg out. Whoop, same thing. So I'm using my head a lot. To help power myself. So if you're holding a lot of neck tension, this is going to feel really uncomfortable to you. So if you can eliminate that and think about your body being long and your head just kind of like, woo, long for the ride, that might be helpful. So we're going to do this and we're going to do right, left, right, left. And I will dance the whole time. And then I'm going to keep the music playing. And then keep going. Just keep going. You can do it 2 more times. You can do it 4 more times. However much, you're just dancing it out. If you wanted to like be stuck on one moment, they're like, oh, I really want to go over this one moment. Do that repetitively. That's fine too. That's like your second to dance. And then we'll call it good. So right, left with me. And then on your own for just a little bit.
Here we go. Calling, 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 calling on me. I'll be there for you. Calling, 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 calling on me. Forever running to you. I'll be on time. Like you expect me to. Calling, 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 calling on me.
Bumps and rungs. All right then. True love never fail. Love never fall. Real love conquer. Want to be easy to pain and all your frustration to be gone. Hey, fade away. I'll be there to give you what you need. I support your cause in selflessly. Yeah, I got you. Just like you would do for me without a plea.
Homework is just like, whew, like let your head fly and then see if you can really try and invest in your shoulders going wide so that they don't come with you, because that's when it really hurts to move your head when your shoulders are coming up but then you're trying to do it. So try and like and experiment with like what your head can actually do. So a lot of time when we use our head, what we try and do is we start to let it go and then we stop it because we get scared. And so what you want to do is actually not helping you, that's actually making it harder to balance. So if you can let your head go and then you can keep it moving far away from you, that's when you really do those sailing turns and that's when you really find freedom. Yeah, yes, exactly. And that's exactly what you should do, Kathy. Like practice it into moves that you know and feel comfortable doing and then just get comfortable using your head. It took me just so many years to really use my head in a way that was helpful to me. And so I would love if I could help you guys do that sooner rather than later. So yeah, this is something you can do for homework later if you want the combo. As always, DM me. I always have videos of myself doing it. So if you want to practice it later on, that's great. Okay, hope you have a great day. And then let me know, give me feedback on this new time if you like it better. If you like the lunch break time better than the 11:30, let me know. And have a great day. Bye, guys.